Greetings, all. It's the Devious Monkey here. All right, I'm out and about. Three ships is right over there, and I came down to get some bean. It's a gorgeous day out. Right now, I'm underneath this section of trees that actually the leaves are changing color, so it's a little bit more rustly than in other places, but that's cool. So let's see, what did I want to talk about? All right, so I did a video the other day about not sort of jumping on the bandwagon, not giving in to the hype of buying the newest, latest, greatest, because in the creator world, we've been inundated with a bunch of new stuff over the past 3 weeks, like a crazy amount of gear. Most important to me, the Sony a7 IV, the Sony 70-200 f2.8 G Master version 2, and the MacBook Pros with the M1 Pro and M1 Max chips. And there's a ton of other stuff out there, you know, like that DJI Ronin 4D, which I have absolutely no interest in. The bottom line is that a ton of stuff has been released and will continue to be released throughout the rest of the year. And the gist of my video was that you don't have to go out and buy all that shit just because some influencer told you to do it. Back in the old days, a long time ago, I used to argue that I was told, do you really need that? And my reply was always, if I want it, I need it. And I used to just buy whatever the hell I wanted. Well, not much has changed. I still buy whatever the hell I want because I want it. It has nothing to do with need, want, or any of that kind of stuff. It's because I want it. Obviously, if you've followed me on this channel, you've seen the massive amounts of gear that I have bought over the last, we'll just say 3 or 4 years. I've switched camera systems. I've bought so many lenses and really so many cameras, trying to find what worked best for me and what I got the perfect flow for. I am very happy with my A7 R4 for stills and this Sony A7C for filming and pictures as well, but mostly I've been using it for filming a lot. Okay, so now we move on to the last thing that I feel like I need, and that is a new MacBook. The MacBook that I have is a 2015 like Retina display. It was the lowest base model, 8 gigs of RAM and a 256 hard drive. You know, it was great. I enjoyed it. It was like my first MacBook after like 10 years. I had a 17-inch PowerBook, when they call them that, a long time ago, but that was before Mac was widely accepted like it is now. So I was a big seller on eBay, and eBay was Mac unfriendly, and it was a pain in the ass to carry two computers around. So I just sold it, and I went into the Windows world, and I was there until I bought that MacBook Pro. So I used that MacBook Pro a lot. I loved it, still have it. Problem is that it had a massive battery expansion to the point where it has bent the computer inside and out. It was gonna cost me $300 to get it fixed, and I refused to put that money into it when I could put $300 into a brand new computer. Now, I have been researching the new MacBook Pros with the M1 Pro chipset and the M1X that just came out and all that kind of stuff, and I started specking it out, and I was like, you know, I've had this computer for 6 years, it's time to upgrade anyways, definitely time to upgrade because I'm afraid to use it because of the battery expansion, even though the Genius Bar told me that it should be done, but I still feel like it's getting bulgier. I researched and I had come up to a specced out design in my head that was going to cost me $3,100 before taxes. And I thought that will future proof me for a long time. It should be awesome. And the more I thought about it and the more videos I watched, the more I realized that was freaking stupid, that I did not need to spend that kind of money. My wife also has the same MacBook Pro that I have, because I bought mine, she liked it, so I bought her one. And hers has started to get all wonky. I gave her an external keyboard and a mouse now so that she can use that, and it's a big pain in the ass. So I bought her a MacBook Air, and that was gonna be her big Christmas present. But the problem is that I didn't wanna buy it and have it sit there for 2 months untouched and have something like you open the box and it's messed up. So I had to tell her about it. And it's nothing new. I constantly buy her gifts for like her birthday or Christmas, and I end up giving them to her like months in advance because I'm weird that way. I just love giving her stuff. I talked to her last night and I told her, I said, I didn't want to tell you, but I have to, blah, 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 blah. I bought you a MacBook Air. It'll be here on Monday. Now, I did not spec that out crazy like I would for me, because she doesn't use her computer that way. She has a separate gaming laptop that she finally bought, and she plays games on that, and then she does everything else on her MacBook. She was pretty close up to the 256 gig hard drive, filling it up, although that included a lot on the iCloud drive, which gets included in the configuration of how much memory you're using. But I was like, eh, screw it. So she's getting the 8 gig RAM, but I bumped it to a 512 hard drive. And it's the 8-core CPU, 8-core GPU version, not the 8 and 7. So she's going to be set for a long time, provided it doesn't screw up. Knock on wood. Then, after researching all that, I decided that a MacBook Air would actually be a perfect machine for me as well. I started searching and researching it and looking at Amazon and the Apple site and B&H and this, that, and the other thing. And when it came right down to it, I found what I think is the perfect machine for me in the Apple refurb section. So I bought it last night, and that is a 8-core, 16 gig, 1 terabyte model. And because it was in the refurb, it was like $250 less than buying it brand new. And that'll be here on Tuesday. And then that will take care of that. Then what I plan to do is, after she gets all of the shit off of her old MacBook Pro, we'll wipe it, and then I'm gonna sell that back to Apple, and they'll give you $300 for it, which I think is what they said. So that $300, then when I sell that back, I can use that to pay the $300 fee to have mine redone, because they said that they'd have to take everything out, replace everything. It'd be like a brand new computer, but it would be $300. I'll use the $300 from the sale of hers and then have mine fixed for that $300, and it's kind of a wash. And then I'll basically have a brand new 2015 MacBook Pro. And then I actually plan on giving that to somebody. I haven't decided who, a couple people that I'm thinking about that are in need, and I'm gonna hook them up. That's where I'm at. Now, I know that I was like, you don't need to buy the newest toys and all that kind of stuff, and I'm really not. I'm still sticking to my guns. I decided not to spend $3,200, or by the time it's done, it's probably gonna be $3,400 on one new super duper latest and greatest. Now I'm spending less than that on two MacBook Airs, and I'm taking care of my wife and me, still with like $1,000, if not more, left over from what I would have spent on just mine. And that's what I'm talking about not having to get the latest and greatest. You got to do your research. You got to decide what you need. But I'm also a firm believer on not skimping, because if you skimp and you try to cheap out, you end up buying shit twice, because the piece of crap that you bought in the first place isn't going to do what you needed to do. And then you're going to end up having to buy what you should have gotten in the first place. So I research pretty much, if I spend more than $50, I research the shit out of everything to make sure that I'm making the most educated decision that is going to do what I needed to do and allow me to have what I want to have. So, all right, that's it. I just sort of wanted to give an explanation of that, so that everybody doesn't think, oh, he was just, you know, talking about not going out and buying shit, you know, and he said he wasn't going to buy anything, and then he went out and bought stuff. Remember, my MacBook Pro is pretty much unusable with that expanded battery, and hers is, like, we have to jury-rig parts into it to get it, and they're 6 years old, so I don't think it's unreasonable to replace a computer after 6 years, especially since she uses hers every day. I would be using mine every day, except that I'm afraid to use it. And that's it. That's all I wanted to talk about. Once those units come in, hers on Monday, mine on Wednesday, so when I get back from my route at, you know, on Wednesday, I should be able to go to the UPS store and my computer should be waiting for me. So I'll shoot a video and I'll talk about it, and I'll get all my stuff on there, and I'll see how everything works, and see if I made a mistake and I should have just splurged and gotten the newest MacBook Pros, or if this is going to be, and as I think, leaps and bounds ahead of my 2015 version that I used to edit on. We'll see how that goes. Keep an eye out. That's it. That's all I got today. As always, thank you for joining me. Be sure to like and subscribe. And remember, kids, forward and up.